The text tool lets you create text brushes by using installed system fonts or bitmap fonts. System fonts can usually be scaled freely in size because they are based on curves and paths and not on bitmaps or pixels. With system fonts, the characters use a single color. You can select any color from your palette and stamp the text brush down. With Promotion NG, you can use bitmap fonts that are made from a single image containing the letters and symbols. With bitmap fonts, characters have a fixed size and can use multiple colors. The space character width can be defined separately. Bitmap fonts have their own color palette. If it does not match the palette you are using, then there are two ways to deal with that. You can use a separate layer. If the G sign in the layer window is disabled, then every layer has its own color palette. Apply the font color palette to the new layer. Or you can remap the text's colors to use your global color palette. The quality of the results will vary depending on if your current palette contains colors similar to the ones used by the font in any of the color indices. This can also be done automatically when creating the text brush. You can create such bitmap fonts using a very simple technique to define an image that contains all required characters. Start a new project and select bitmap font as the project type. Define a canvas size that has at least the desired font height and is wide enough to contain a couple of characters in a row. You can change the canvas size later if there is not enough space. The very first row of pixels within the image serves as indicators for the character positions. At the Dimensions panel, you can see the character that is currently under the mouse cursor, which is invalid until we define a first indicator pixel. Place a pixel of any color at the top left corner of the canvas. Now you can see that the Dimensions panel shows an exclamation mark as the current character. Place another pixel with the same color to define the start of the next character, which is a double quote. The order of the characters is based on the ASCII standard. You can find a complete list in the bitmap fonts primer of the documentation file. You can add multiple indicator pixels quickly with the line tool set up to create dots every specified number of pixels. It's suggested to add some key characters like 0 or A for easier navigation. Insert some pixel columns and draw the characters as a rough sketch. For this example, we'll create the set of characters we used for displaying keyboard shortcuts in the tutorial videos. Use the brush pickup tool with the right mouse button to remove elements. This is faster than erasing with the painting tool. Transparency mode auto of the brush pickup tool will use the color of the four corner pixels as transparent if they match. If they don't match, then the brush will also use transparent portions as if they were opaque, and you can replace opaque pixels with transparent pixels on the canvas by just stamping down the brush. To create a simple drop shadow, just pick up the object as a brush, turn it into a single color, and select a shadow color. Use the selection function to protect the object from being modified and stamp the brush to the desired shadow direction. Since we use the shape as background for every character, we can pick it up along with an indicator pixel and copy it side by side on the canvas. To do this, we use the line tool with the option to set a dot every 40 pixels because our brush is 40 pixels wide. While drawing the line, you can scroll the canvas by leaving it with the mouse toward the direction you want to reach. Move farther away to scroll faster. Now we'll simply use a system font to create letters and numbers in our keyboard key shapes. You can use the cursor keys to scroll the canvas while keeping the brush in place. Hold the Shift key and move horizontally to prevent vertical movement. To make positioning easier, you can enable a horizontal ruler using the grid settings. You can use one of the predefined grid definitions that you don't need and modify it to your needs. For our font, we don't need characters like the exclamation mark, so we'll use these keys to represent things like the shift key. After insertion of empty pixel columns to increase background size, you can fill the gap by simply drawing with the required shape you pick up as a brush. The ruler we defined previously now helps us to place the text brush correctly without needing to see the other characters, 0 and 1, we placed earlier at a very distant position. After defining some characters, we might need more space on the canvas. Use the frame resize function to enlarge the canvas while keeping current contents on the left side. To check the font, we can directly create a text brush based on the current bitmap font project. Active bitmap font projects are listed at the top of all bitmap fonts. Copy the brush image to the clipboard to use the text in other software packages where you can paste image data. Finally, if your font is finished, you can store it as an image file to PromotionNG's Fonts folder. This will list it in the bitmap font selection the next time you start PromotionNG and use the text tool. Thanks very much for watching and happy creating with PromotionNG.